नमस्ते नमस्ते, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी. दिस इज माय वेरी इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग आई वांट टू हियर इज वर्ल्ड ब्लू जोन्स. वर्ल्ड ब्लू जोन्स मीन्स एक्चुअली इट वाज रिटन बाय डैन बटनर. ही वाज बेसिकली अ रिपोर्टर. ही आइडेंटिफाइड दैट देयर आर फाइव एरियाज इन द वर्ल्ड व्हिच आर हैविंग हाई डेंसिटी ऑफ सेंटेनेरियंस, 100 ईयर्स ओल्ड पीपल. 100 years of old people are localized in these five areas. Those are Sardinia, Italy, Okinawa, Japan, Loma Linda, California, Nicoya Peninsula, Costa Rica, and Ikaria, Greece. So he went to these five places, spending around 10 years, and he wrote a book. How these people lived for 100 years? Why there is a density of 100 years centenarians localized in these five areas? What are their special lifestyle? What was their diet pattern? Whether they are affected by the diseases or not? All these things were identified by him. Then he wrote that ultimately these people managed to live longer and better is not through pills. He identified that it is not because of medicine and because of surgery or because of corporate hospital system available there. It is only because they have a regulated lifestyle, regulated diet habits, and their very perspective of life is something entirely different from the other people. That what he wants to portray. So he focused in his book World Blue Jones. I would like to advise all the people who are listening to me can go through this and being impressed by this, because they are very close to the expressions of Ayurveda. Now if you see here, so diabetes has reached epidemic proportions worldwide, you know, and along with cardiovascular diseases, it has become a leading cause of death. Emphasizes many detection, prevention, and cost-effective strategies. So these are the burdens of healthcare all over the world. You see here in 2015, around 415 million people had only type 2 diabetes in 2015. By 2040, it will be projected as 642 million people by 2040. That means this is called statistical projection. This problem is going to cause a major issue to the future generation. Now coming to the very important aspects which I want to quote here, diabetes will increase by 150% in the next 25 years. And trends towards obesity, unhealthy diets, and sedentary lifestyles are very important causes for developing this disease. Now, if you see here, this is the 2015 and 2040 projections. There is a dubious distinction of India occupying the second position in the world, as 69.2 million people are affected by 2015, projected to be 123.5 million people going to be affected by 2040 as per the statistical projections. So if you see here, another important thing which I want to quote here is 3.2 million deaths every year, and 20 deaths is attributable to diabetes, and 8,700 deaths every day, 6 deaths every minute. You can imagine what a major issue it is for the health conditions of the world. At least 1 in 10 deaths among the adults between 35 to 64. This young population, productive population, are affected by the fatality. So in this condition, very important thing which I want to focus here is 3/4 of the deaths among people with diabetes aged under 35 years are due to their conditions. That means their lifestyle and other things. So diabetes is a life-threatening condition. You can say that it is not a simple thing. It is a life-threatening condition. Now, if you see here, the rise of number of cases diabetes mainly Asian Indian phenotype. We are particularly China and Indian population are more affected as per the records and statistics. And urbanization, sedentary habits are very important causes for predisposition. Type 2 diabetes accounts more than 90% of the diabetics globally. And westernization, increased rates of obesity are another issue. Genetic susceptibility for diabetes and also lower threshold limit for environmental risk factors are also the another fact about the diabetes. So if you see here, the very important thing is every fifth person with the diabetes in the world would be an Indian. 1 million Indians die due to diabetes every year. one quarter that of urban population. So they are, even rural population is one third, one fourth, and urban population is three fourth in India if you see. So it is going to cause a 30.8 billion global market for distribution or marketing of the medicines and allied things. Even it has a market of diabetic devices, and diabetic market size will be, so anti-diabetic market size will be like this. So if you see here, there's a potential area in the world. The major problem in the world is now diabetes. So now if you see here, good management and many complications of diabetes can be prevented. If you properly manage that, the diabetic complications can be prevented or delayed. And effective management includes lifestyle measures such as diet, physical activity, maintain appropriate weight, and smoking. So Ayurveda always approach any disease trifold way. Aushad, Ahar, Vihar. So Aushad means managing with medicine and other procedures, diet management, and also lifestyle correction. All this threefold approach is a very, very essential thing for the diabetes. So this approach was already identified in Ayurvedic classics long back, but it is only identified in the context of diabetes or some other few diseases in the modern system of medicine. So medication often has an important role to play, no doubt, but particularly for the blood glucose correction and blood pressure correction, blood lipids correction. So a full and healthy life is possible with diabetes if you properly manage that, or if you properly correct your lifestyle, diet, and medical management. So now let me say the very important things here is the type 1 diabetes is not yet possible because its prevention is not in our hands, and it only occupies the adjunct of around less than 10% of the diabetic population. So we need not worry about that, and we are concentrating more on the type 2 diabetes because it can be managed, it can be corrected, the prevention of the forthcoming complications can be managed through Ayurvedic principles, and all these things are which are in our limitation when we manage the type 2 diabetes. Finnish diabetes prevention study showed that better diet, increased physical activity, and modest weight loss could substantially reduce the development of type 2 diabetes in middle-aged people. So it also gives an importance for our principles to support that approach of diet, drug, and lifestyle correction are very, very essential to manage this. Coming to the very important things, another issues related to that is diabetes mellitus having high elevated risk of cancer. This is another important area. So because if you see, these are the colorectal, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, breast, endometrial, ovaries, prostate, kidney, thyroid, lymphoma. These are the different types of cancers which can be very high risk in the individuals more than 60 years, especially the diabetes group. So that means individuals with the diabetes having more or greater risk of getting the cancers rather than the normal individuals. And another important thing is association between early control of glucose levels and early control of HbA1c reduction in cardiovascular events and mortality is having some link. That means if you correct properly these things, biochemical correction of the diabetics, and incidentally it is going to even prevent the cardiovascular events and mortality in type 2 diabetes. So that is the reason why it is very clear that controlling the glucose levels in diabetics are very, very, very important, and in addition to that, to improve the quality of life also. So relative risks are also there. Other than the cancer, eye events decrease by 13% if you properly follow the diet, lifestyle, and diet regularly. Kidney events by 20%. Nerve events were not reduced, especially in middle-aged group, when you even you control the glucose levels. So the very important thing is to control the glucose levels in the blood. So in the diabetics, by three means, that is diet, drug, and lifestyle correction, so you are going to minimize the risk of cancer. you are also going to minimize the eye complications, renal complications, but neurological complications are not even concerned, not even influenced by even correction of that. That means it is very important. So we have to correct the neurological complications at a very early stage. So increased risk of hypoglycemia is there in the modern insulin therapy. Suppose insulin, many people think that insulin is a very panacea and we can even manage the type 2 diabetes also. But that is not correct. The studies show that insulin therapy is having high risk of hypoglycemia. Severe insulin resistance is also identified. And sometimes even 200 units per day is also advised by the Diabetes Association of America because of the resistance developed by them. Suggest to go for combination therapy including one or more non-insulin agents. So even insulin therapy is not even an effective measure for the type 2 diabetes. So because it is going to cause the resistance in the insulin resistance is experienced by the patient. Even they require higher quantities of insulin, which are going to have some complications over the body. So if you see here, the criteria for diagnosis, there are frequently modified criteria is there. So very frequently they readjust the criteria to diagnose the diabetes. But these are the things which are recently prevailing. HbA1c equal or more or less 6.5%. But this also, as per the age, there is a modifications given. And fasting glucose levels more or less are equal or more than 126 mg per deciliter. And 2 hours plasma glucose is equal or more than 200 mg per deciliter. That is also oral glucose tolerance test average. Symptoms of hyperglycemia and casual plasma glucose is more than 200 mg, you can determine them as diabetics. So fasting is defined as no caloric intake for at least 8 hours. 8 hours, there should not be any either liquid or solid calories intake before testing that. And similarly, glucose tolerance test is done by 75 grams of glucose dissolved in water and given, and series of blood samples are collected. Now, this is also another area, diabetes, pre-diabetic 125 mg or up to 100 mg is the pre-diabetic stage. Less than 100 mg of fasting plasma glucose is considered as normal. These are the normal parameters and variable time to time. We have to tune to that American Diabetes Association, which is promulgating the criteria time to time every 2 years, once in 2 years. So, ABC, to remember all these things, very important is whenever you come across a diabetic, we have to think about the HbA1c levels, maintenance of HbA1c level, tight levels, and blood pressure of the diabetics must be regulated, and dyslipidemia should be corrected. So ABC is related to A for HbA1c, B stands for blood pressure, C for the cholesterol or dyslipidemia. Now, if you see here, the type 2 diabetes, there are two issues. Impaired insulin action, that is going to cause the impact over the rise of glucose levels. Similarly, there is a B cell dysfunction and death. This supplying the inadequate insulin, and this insulin inadequacy also going to cause hyperglycemia. So both ways, it can either by impairing the production of insulin or the insulin sensitivity is reduced at the periphery. Both are issues of the type 2 diabetes. So if you here see high fat and overweight, sedentary lifestyle, smoking, high blood pressure, all these factors are further aggravate the condition, further dispose them to, further predispose them to the complicated state. So these have to be corrected whenever we are treating the diabetics. So usually whenever you see the diabetics, so there are modifiable and non-modifiable risk factors, we can say. Modifiable means we can correct them. For example, dietary factors. If there is an erroneous diet being accepted by the patients, then that has to be corrected by the physician. And other modifiable factors like hypertension and HDL, good cholesterol reduction, increased triglycerides, obesity, previously identified glucose intolerance, all these are modifiable factors. We can modify them. But non-modifiable factors are there which are not in our control, like history of gestational diabetes, family history, and polycystic ovarian syndrome, ethnicity. So these are not in our control. We have to accept them and we have to accordingly regulate their. So now if you come to Ayurvedic part, so this is about the things which are prevailing in the world about the diabetes, and it must be treated pradipta garavat sikram. That means you have to correct it like a burning house is burning, how we act immediately. Similarly, we have to act in these conditions. So as you know well, these are the causative factors mentioned in the classics, Asya Sukham, Swapna Sukham, Dadhini, Gramyodha Kanu Parasah Payamsi, Navanna Panam, Gudavaikutamsya. So this is a very popular quotation. Many of you are well known about that. I am not going to deal much with this, but it is going to cause calorie conservation is one aspect. Calorie consumption, high calorie consumption is another aspect. But absolutely it is fit to the advancements which are taken place even the present arena on diabetes. These causative factors are fit into, because either calorie utilization is less, calorie consumption is high. These two are the factors for the diabetes. So now if you see here, there are prabhuta avilamutrata is the symptom described in Madhav Nidan. Prabhuta means increased frequency. Avilamutrata means there is some content other than the normal urine. So there is some content which is there, but usually it is the sweetness which is there in the urine, which is not supposed to be there. So that is called madhurya. So based on that, diabetes is identified. If you see the prodromal symptoms, very important things are identified, even the recent researches. What they say? Svedam. Anga gandha means sweat coming from the skin, because once they sweat out, bacterial growth can be possible. Anga sandhilyatvam. So that is a degeneration in the angas. And you can see here, Shaya Asana Swapna Sukhe. That is a feeling of, that means he wants always to assume the comfortable position which he wants to enjoy that. So Sita Priyatvam, Galatalu Sosha, Madhuryam Asye, Karapada Daha. This I want to explain here, Karapada Daha. So usually when you think that Karapada Daha is usually a neuropathy condition, we come across in the advanced stage of the diabetic neuropathy. But recent researches, recent publications, and a research work conducted in SV Institute of Medical Sciences shows that many of the pre-diabetics having the neuropathic symptomatology, like burning sensation, numbness, all these things are seen in these people. So this is a very, very important thing. That means prodromal symptoms are usually seen in the pre-diabetic stage. The pre-diabetic stage, all these symptomatology are going to predispose them for the diabetes. So we have to be very careful. Even Panipada Daha is also seen in the pre-diabetic stage and advanced diabetic stage. Both stages, this can be seen. This was identified and a paper was published in the medical journal also, that pre-diabetic stage patient manifests certain neurological problems, and even advanced stage of diabetes as a peripheral neuropathy, the problems are also being manifested. So these are the things, because you see everything, even tartar accumulation is also noted in Ayurvedic classics. Suppose if you go for the modern, the polyuria, polydipsia, polyphagia, all these are nothing but eliminating the sugar from the urine. So these are the manifestation to empty the sugar levels which are increased in the plasma through urine. All these manifestations, polyuria number of times, even more water is lost, then naturally the thirst is increased, and usually the patients increased hunger to take food. These are all things. Recurrent infections are also seen unexplained weight loss is also seen in these people, because usually many diabetics, incidentally, they are found with either weight loss or neurological problems. Your neurological problems means, so usually neurological problems related to. So now the classification, if you see in Ayurvedic classics, is a sahaja prameha, apatya nimittaja prameha. So sahaja prameha, there is a lot of discussion about that, how it, because the grandfather's father, it runs in families, that can be considered, that is because of the bija dosha. And this was discussed, and it is considered as asatya. And apatya nimittaja prameha is also avrata condition. So this is also mentioned, and this can be managed with the krutra sajjaments, with the difficult, and if you manage, you can manage that, not a problem at all. So if you see here, there is another classification related to the management of diabetes, that is madhumeha in Ayurveda, that they also say stula prameha, krisha prameha. Even if you see the modern system also classifies the patients of diabetics with obese diabetic and non-obese diabetic. Obese diabetic, they go for such therapies which are going to sensitize the peripheral insulin receptors, utilization of the glucose, and inhibition of the absorption of glucose. And obese, lean and thin diabetics, they have a different approach. They go for sulfonylureas or insulin. They're all going to increase the plumpness in them. So similarly, we have also this type of stula pramehi and krusha pramehi. There are two concepts discussed in Ayurvedic classics in the context of the Chikitsa Sutra of the diabetes. So Ayurveda emphasized that the first and foremost principle of prevention as well as the treatment is sanchepadaha priyayogo nidana parivarjanam. So the very first aspect of treating any disease is first to stop exposing to the etiological factors. That's a very, very important thing. Without this, even if you do the management, it is ineffective. Sometimes it is not going to give the expected results also. So what are those actually curds, use of milk preparations, flesh of domestic aquatic animals, water of rivers, tanks during rain and flood, new grains, puddings made of jaggery. So all these are very elaborately discussed in classics, that what has to be taken and what not to be taken. So restrict heavy diets, fatty foods, increase body weight and lipids, cholesterol. Avoid sleep during the daytime, and lethargy, that means physical activity, is also advised in Ayurvedic classics. So diabetes can cause increased risk of other factors also. In addition, we are earlier discussed about the cancer, and in addition to that, another major problem which going to land into the fatality is heart problems, stroke, eyesight problems, kidney problems, food problems, and neuropathies. So these are all called upadravas. Even the context of upadrava, Vrana also said as, even these also carbuncles are also said as upadravas for the that is pitaka. Pitaka is also one of the upadravas discussed in Ayurvedic classics, that we will discuss in the later stage. So what is our aim? So to avoid hyperglycemia, that means to control the glucose levels. Instability in blood glucose over time, that means fluctuant diabetics used to come to us. That means hyperglycemia control is one aspect, but the fluctuations will be seen in them. Sometimes it finds that it go beyond even 300 mg, and sometimes it will be in the 150 to 200 ranges. So that is called instability. Instability in blood glucose over time is going to cause harmful effects, that is complicated stage of the diabetes. So at this stage, this is a very ideal area to intervene by Ayurvedic doctors, because once you start giving treatment, stability will be restored in blood glucose levels. And another is preventing, delaying the development of complications due to diabetes without having any adverse effects on the quality of life. So modern system having these three, but these three are very important for all also, because the adverse effects have to be minimized, complications have to be prevented, and quality of life has to be improved. So it comes to the quality of life. There is no systematic medicine which is available in modern system. Only glucose levels are apparently maintained. By normalizing the glucose also, patient feels lassitude, exhaust nature, and postponement nature. All these things are seen, but quality of life is also gradually decreasing. But by introducing the Ayurvedic medicine, the quality of life can be improved. So the individual approach is also there, because Purusham Purusham Vichya is our concept, but even modern system also says, based on the age, you have to intervene. Body weight, based on the body weight, based on the macrovascular or microvascular complications, you have to intervene. Duration of the diabetes, chronicity, based on the chronicity, your approach is different. Expectancy of life. So these are all ABCD, if you remember that. So that the individual approach is very, very important. Now, what are the line of treatments available? So nutritional therapy, diet. Diet is a very, very important factor. If you ignore the diet, the other things, pachye sati gadarthasya kima ushadha nishevanai. Pachye asati gadarthasya kima ushadha nishevanai. That means, if you do not take proper food, what is the fun of using the medicine? If you do not use the proper food, even if you use the medicine, it is ineffective. That's what the Ayurvedic classics say. That is 100% true in the context of diabetes and also true in other disease conditions also. The physical exercise and yoga, this is also exhaustively mentioned in Ayurvedic classics. Physical exercise has to be done, that we are going to discuss in the course of this presentation. So oral hypoglycemic drugs, the correcting the glucose levels in the body. So this is this, and n number of drugs are identified, and they have influence on the glucose normalizations. Insulin, incretin mimetic therapies are also there. Insulinomimetic drugs, incretin mimetic drugs, that means insulinogenic drugs. There are certain herbs which are identified, which are going to produce the insulin like substances in the body and which are going to normalize the glucose levels. So now these are, I don't want to focus much upon this, because these are the modern line of treatment. But these modern line of treatment, they also say, either in the monotherapy or in combination, the modern doctors used to prescribe the treatment for the diabetics. So if you see here, drug regimen and complications. So if you see, all the drugs having some complications, because you know, many of the drugs in modern system having adverse drug reactions. ADRs are very common in modern system, because unwanted pharmacological effect of the drug is nothing but ADR, adverse drug reaction. So adverse drug reactions are there for almost all oral hypoglycemic drugs. So we have to keep all those things in the mind. So disorders associated with the diabetes, I will discuss in the course of time. Now we are going to understand this alternative systems of medicine. Why we need Ayurvedic system or other systems to intervene here when there is an effective treatments available in modern system. So need for a collaborative therapy with the potential to reduce the blood sugar level in synergy with the regular allopathic medication, thereby controlling diabetes without having to increase the dose of allopathic medicines, long-term therapy, and improve the quality of life in the patients. So there are two issues. One is, their approach of managing the diabetes is always step-up therapy. So if they start with single drug, the dose will be increased in the course of time, and it will be again further enhanced into double drug, triple drug, or even taking into insulin along with oral hypoglycemics. Like that, it is only a step-up therapy. Regularly, they go on increasing the doses, and majority of these oral hypoglycemics are modern drugs having lot of complications. That also we know. So this is a gap here. So one is, we have to control their increasing dose system. That means, that is one important thing. So another is, even if the glucose levels are well maintained by modern drugs, quality of life is not seen. So that is, many patients used to complain to Ayurvedic doctors that I do not have quality of life. I feel exhausted. My personal life is inactive. And these things are usually mentioned. This gap is there in modern management. So this gap can be possibly filled up by alternative systems of medicine, having blood sugar lowering effect without any side effect, that is protecting the normal organ functioning and improving the quality of life. These two are the very essential things contributed from Ayurvedic system. So if you see, the plants are basically, we depend from the very birth onwards, we depend on plants for all our livelihood. So if a product or a medicine which has come from the plant or the congenial to the human body, non-toxic in nature, effective remedies for chronic diseases, we can use even for longer period also without any problem. To associate complications, synthetic drugs, there has been shifting towards natural remedies for diabetes. So even WHO also say 80% of the population in the world once in their lifetime used the herbal medicine. So that is the tendency now. The population want to go for the safe remedies. They identified that the chemicals having a lot of side effects. So treatment of diabetes with medicinal plants is focused on controlling, lowering blood glucose, protecting the target organs from the damage, improving the quality of life. So these three are very essential things: blood glucose correction and target organ complications can be minimized and quality of life can be improved. So use of complementary alternative medicine is common for the prevention and treatment of chronic diseases, believed to be safe, effective and convenient, especially in the context of diabetes. So applied principles of management, if you see here, to improve the stress adaptation. Stress is one of the important factors to predispose the even genetic proneness of the individual towards diabetes into diabetics. So that is one aspect. We have to take care of the stress whenever you deal with a diabetic. Regulated diet. Diet, you have to advocate the diet every time. Whenever the patient comes to you, we have to even reaffirm the diet importance in their life. Regular exercises also has to be focused. So optimum sleep, also very important. That is more than 6 hours, less than 8 hours. This is less than 8 hours a day. And relaxation practice of yogas are very important. Yogic asanas are also good. So now ICMR also have come down, and that they say that the use of indigenous drugs from Indian traditional system of medicine like Ayurveda, homeopathy, Unani are recommended for the management of type 2 diabetes. So they advise these things, quoting certain examples, that these medicines are very safe. And for safety study and mechanism of actions are needed prior to treatment schedule. If new drugs are going to be introduced, their safety studies have to be conducted. And then once they are found safe, they can be used for that purpose. So now, how these herbs, Ayurvedic herbs, having influence or involving the glucose levels in control. So it may stimulate the beta cells to secrete more insulin. That certain drugs are identified, increase the sensitivity of insulin receptors, that is also to utilization of insulin at the periphery is improved, and carbohydrate absorption in the gut like methi, that will be inhibited and stops further destruction of beta cells, facilitate their regeneration, amla and punarnava. This is having antioxidant property, and free radical corrections are done by these drugs. Prevents breakdown of starches. This is also methi, neem. So I will explain you the effects of these in the course of my lecture. Prevents glycogenolysis and gluconeogenesis. This is kalme, katki. So bitter drugs having this quality. Increases peripheral utilization of glucose by tulasi and guduchi. These are some of the aspects where we identified through some of the researches conducted. So this I want to focus here. This was a meta analysis done on the randomized control cells, RCTs. So usually RCT is a number two evidence for the quality of the research. Number one is meta analysis of the RCTs of two or more. So now this study is on 26 trials with a total of 4,169 participants. So this acts actually on traditional patent Chinese medicine. What they ultimately resolved is reduce the risk of progression to type 2 diabetes and increase the possibility of regression towards the normoglycemia. This was identified by this study, which was published in 2017, Diabetes Research and Clinical Practices. So this is very, very important because meta-analysis of RCTs more than two can be considered as golden standard in the research evidence. So these are certain drugs which you many of you know, because around 200 to 300 Ayurvedic herbs are identified with hypoglycemic effect. So some of these are narrated here. Now we'll go for one after another because accumulating the evidences from various research activities. So Bilwa, eagle marmalus, you know. So this eagle marmalus is used by naturopaths and Ayurvedic doctors. Ayurvedic doctors use it in diabetes around 72%. And naturopaths, they use 40%, especially in diabetes. So we also use this eagle marmalus Bilwa in other conditions also, in addition to the diabetes, like diarrhea, dysentery, acidity, gastric ulcer, cholesterolemia, edema, fever, ophthalmic problems and arthritis, jaundice, conjunctivitis, and so on and so forth. Several other conditions also there. So, but 72% of the utility is there in the diabetes by Ayurvedic doctors on eagle marmalus. So another is Pashanved. Pashanved we widely use for the urinary calculus. So this has direct diabetic controlling nature, as it was experimented on rat models. So rat models show that majority of the herbs having the medicinal value for even other purposes, having the normalizing the glucose levels in the body. So anti-diabetic property of Irwal Annatta. So this is also another that what I told you, Irwal Annatta's Pashanved. It has moderate antioxidant, DPP-4, PTTP-1 inhibition, along with glucose uptake. And this actually, this has hypoglycemic effect by significantly alpha-glucosidase inhibition. So alpha-glucosidase inhibition is very important for breaking the polysaccharides into monosaccharides and polysaccharides into disaccharides and disaccharides into monosaccharides. So alpha-glucosidase enzyme is very important for disintegrating the polysaccharides, that carbohydrates, into monosaccharides, that is glucose molecules at the intestines. So if you inhibit that reaction will be minimized and the absorption of the glucose levels will be minimized. That means the disintegration of the carbohydrate will be minimized. So another is Calotropis gigantea, ARCA. We use for many other purposes, even for Swasa diseases we use, and many other conditions where we use. But Calotropis gigantea is having glycemic and lipid correction activities. This was also identified. So another very important is Cythisium cumini. So this is also widely used by Ayurvedic doctors. And this is a publication from the Sri Lanka. So this evidence-based complementary alternative medicine publication. And this also says that it has a very productive hypoglycemic effect on the rat model. So Gymnema sylvester is another podopathry. The Gymnema sylvester is a very, very important and good mark. And this is also widely used by many Ayurvedic physicians in diabetes. This was also proved effective. So if you see the Sushruta Samhita, Shilajit is discussed a lot, very exhaustively, in the context of Prameha. Because Shilajit is a very, very important drug, which is called as decomposed humus. And this has all these chemical compositions, dibenzopyrans, triterpenes, and fulvic acid, and all this. But fulvic acid increases the superoxide dismutase, it is antioxidant. Superoxide dismutase is a innate antioxidant within the body that is weak. So peripheral neuropathy is also minimized by this. Radicals radical, and that means free radical scavenging effect is identified by Shilajit. So Shilajit is widely used for many purposes because it is a lekhana drug and it can be used even to prevent the atherosclerotic complications. So here if you see, Shilajit is high attitude problems. If you go for the high attitude, oxygen is a problem, oxygenation is a problem. So there was a study conducted at the International Journal of Ayurveda Research, it was published. So if the regular use of the Shilajit is going to minimize the effects of high altitude, that means oxygen saturation is increased by this drug. So Shilajit has many properties and is capable of treating almost all bodily elements. So it is not only for diabetes, but it improves the quality of life in many of the diabetics. And also it is going to minimize the micro and macro angiopathy conditions in the future. So fenugreek is another important thing. So fenugreek is, you know, methika. Methika is also widely discussed in Ayurvedic classics, containing soluble dietary fiber fraction. And galactomannan is a constituent. It is insulinogenic action is there identified by the rat models. So decreases the rate of gastric emptying. So because of that, polyphagia can be corrected. Decreasing the absorption of glucose from the small intestine, it is also going to minimize the absorption levels of the glucose. It regulates the cholesterol, especially LDL will be minimized and HDL is improved. So it eliminates the bile acids through fecal matter. So once the bile is eliminated through fecal matter, usually the major portion of the bile, around 75 to 80% of the bile, is recycled. So bile is nothing but the a product of cholesterol. So if it is more eliminated, means more cholesterol or fat things are being eliminated from the body. That possibility is there with the fenugreek powder. So this was a study conducted by our college with the SV Institute of Medical Sciences, a department of cardiology. And this debitterized fenugreek powder on LDL, VLDL on diabetics. So we conducted on debitterization because patient compliance is one of the important qualities of drug. So bitterness is very essential for diabetes, no doubt. But by removing the saponin, which is there in that methika, is going to minimize the bitterness and patient acceptability is increased. But saponin, which is there in the methika, is going to increase the appetite also in the patients. So that is also known to everybody that tikta rasa pradhan dravyas are going to increase the appetite. So similarly, yet saponin, which is removed from this, is using some technology. Only saponin, which is a matter for the bitterization, that is removed, and the remaining all the phytochemicals are present in this fenugreek. This was a study conducted because this technology of debitterization was inherited from the US. So this was a study conducted in collaboration with the SV Institute of Medical Sciences. So ultimately, what our observation is, you can see here. So the debitterized fenugreek is having cholesterol lowering effect, and also you can see here, LDL also reduced, and in addition to that, it has direct influence on the glucose normalization. So this is another study conducted by our own, you can see the Murali Krishna here, and this is a Sri Venkateswara University and our college, a collaborative study on rat models. Actually, we have a preparation called Madhunaram, so which contains a few herbs which are having excellent hypoglycemic effect. So we conducted a study with the antioxidant activity and hypoglycemic, that means anti-diabetic activity of this for the herbal formulation, and this is published in Journal of Pharmacy and Chemistry. So you can see also it is available in the. So usually this is having very important ingredients like Sygesium Humani, Philanthus Emblica, Curcuma Langa and Gymnema Sylvester. Only four drugs are there, this poly herbal compound. This is having a different anti-diabetic, antioxidant activity of polyherbal formulation could be due to different types of phytoconstituents from various plants, which may have different mode. Okay, and these are all identified, and this paper is available in the net. You can browse it, not a problem. So methotrexates are also having some effect. This was Chandolaji, so one of my seniors, Bhatia and Chandolaji, his publication here. So he shows that methotrexates also having, because stress adaptation is a very important area for the diabetics. You have to think about the methotrexates administration in the diabetics. No way they are connected to the glucose levels, but by adopting the stress, and stress adaptation is one of the important factors to minimize the free radical production and damage caused to the various tissues of the body, developing the forthcoming complications. Methotrexates are also very important areas which I want to focus. Next is the nephropathy is another issue. Kidney is usually affected in diabetics. Commonest cause of renal failure is diabetes only. 50% of dialysis patients have diabetes. 30% of patients with type 1 and type 2 renal failures. So that means grade 1, grade 2 develop renal failures. So 30% of patients with type 1 and type 2 diabetes develop renal failure. That's also there. This number will increase as the diabetic population is increasing. So this is a normal kidney. You can see the diabetic kidney when shrunken. So here very important is the manifestations, clinical syndrome consisting of, so if more than 25 years elapse, unlikely to develop nephropathy. So usually 25 years of diabetic can develop nephropathy. Otherwise, if it is not controlled, protein in urine, high blood pressure, decline in renal function manifested with raised creatinine and urea levels. And protein in urine is also identified by protein content in the urine, in 24 hours urine protein. So very important thing which I want to focus here, my friends, this is Chandra Prabha Vatika. Chandra Prabha Vati is a very famous drug, you know. So many people are afraid of giving this drug for diabetics, and many people used to or like to even administer this Chandra Prabha Vati for normal diabetics. But I observed in my regular practice, the Chandra Prabha Vati, if it is properly prepared, you try to remember this word, because formula must be properly prepared. Quality of drug is very, very important for a doctor to get the deserved results in the patient. So if name itself is not going to happen, but Chandra Prabha Vatika, so quality Chandra Prabha Vatika is manufactured by certain pharmacies. We have to identify them and properly use this. We can minimize the nephropathy, or we can even prevent the nephropathy, and also we can slow down the process of nephropathy in diabetics, which has been observed here in our day-to-day practice. So another important thing here is Nisha Kathakadi Kashayam, Kathaka Khadiradi Kashayam. These two are very important. Even if you see the Charaka Samhita, kashayas are widely used for the diabetes management. But these two kashayas, if they are regularly given, they are going to have oral hypoglycemic effect at the same time, and they are going to minimize the complications of the kidney. So Shilajit is also another important, because you know Chandra Prabha Vati contains Shilajit. Properly purified Shilajit is having restoration of the vasculature, which are a microangiopathy. The nephropathy is nothing but a microangiopathy. So this can be minimized by Shilajit administration. Punanava Gochun are also well-known drugs for you. So many of the doctors used to use it. But the other things are my observations. So nephropathy, even you can go for these type of drugs, because many modern doctors used to say that majority of the herbs having high potassium. So potassium excessive use are going to cause worsening of nephropathy. But these are the safe drugs which you can safely due to them. So there will not be any problem of hyperkalemia and going to worsen the condition, as modern doctors used to say. And these are the things you can also see. The early Amlavetasa, Brassica, red cabbage also, Astrolagus membranaceus, and Tubulus terrestris, Tenospora cardifolia. These are the safe drugs. Sometimes you may have a puzzling mind that what has to be used in this condition, what not to be used. But these are the safe drugs which you have to remember. So another important area is retinopathy, because many people become blind because of the retinopathy in uncontrolled diabetes. So if you see here the diabetic eye a bit more, you can see here the early changes of diabetic retinopathy, and you can see further number of the such areas are seen, and you can see here inside the eye you can see the vitreous hemorrhage is taken place in the these are the bleeding inside areas. So sometimes the detachment of the retina takes place and permanent loss can be experienced by the individual. So in that condition, you try to remember that saptamrita loha is very, very important, right? Because many people used to be afraid of using this metallic preparations, but saptamrita loha containing only iron, not a problem at all. And the saptamrita loha beauty is it contains only 5 ingredients. Among that is triphala, yeast, and loha. Triphala, yeast, loha, 5. So why it is called saptamrita means we have to add the ghee and madhu in unequal quantities and to be administered. So along with the anupana, it will become sapta. So that proper administration is also important as per the classics. Suppose if you use with unequal quantities of gogrita and madhu, it will be more effective to prevent the diabetic retinopathy rather than advising the saptamrita loha and administering one tablet twice a day or one tablet thrice a day. Ayaskruti is also another area. So very important. Ayaskruti is used in diabetes and also stolia. And this is also very important drug. Triphala kashayam can be used. Jashita basma, very safe to use. Shilajit, whenever you come across the microangiopathy, you try to remember the shilajit. Anjana, netra tarpana are also very important. Anjana procedures are all very important. Narikel anjana is a very important procedure, but when the huge bleed is there, you need to go for tarpana procedures. You cannot go for the anjana procedures at that time, but early stages of diabetic retinopathy, you can go for anjana procedures. So now coming to these are the drugs which can safely be used. Whatever that the drugs which are available in the market, these drugs are identified to be having the prevention of the diabetic retinopathy. So this is also published from the University of Kashmir, Department of Biotechnology. They worked upon the models and they identified. So these are the drugs actually, if you completely sum up those things, retinopathy, these are the drugs safely can be given for the diabetic retinopathy. Now coming to the neuropathy. Neuropathy is a microangiopathy only, because nerves having a small vasculature, those vasculatures are affected, and those vasculature devoid of circulation lead to the degeneration of the outer layer of the axons, that is axonal layer, that leads to neuropathy. Paresthesias are commonly seen. Either aberrations of sensation or reduced sensations are commonly seen. So in that condition, again Chandraprabhavati, you remember always Shilajit must be used in one or another way. Vasant Kusumakar Ras is another important thing. This is a herbo mineral compound. So major metals are there. You need not worry, but it can be used by our practice. What we use is Vasant Kusumakara is used with unequal quantities of honey and ghee, processed with that means taking the Vasant Kusumakara 100 mg, making into fine powder, adding the madhu and ghrita and unequal quantities, and making into paste, and has to be given in the morning early hours. So this Vasant Kusumakara is only 10 days only. So don't give for longer period, because many people used to give for longer period, but give a gap of another 3 months, and again once in 3 months you can repeat the Vasant Kusumakara use for 10 days. So you can see the quality of life, minimizing the complications, and sensitivity to the insulin receptors are also increased. So these are very important, but if you go on continuously giving the Vasant Kusumakara, it's not going to give much dividends as we observed. So Purna Chandrodaya Ras is also another. Chandana Adivati, you remember always the diabetic neuropathy, whenever there is a paresthesia, hyperesthesias are there, Touch sensation is also not bearable. Burning sensation is there. Chandanadivati is a very, very important drug to be used. If you give 250 mg of Chandanadivati 3 times a day. Balaguluchadi Kashayam is also another important thing for the peripheral vascular problems, even micro or macro angiopathies, especially neurological problems like diabetic neuropathy. Balaguluchadi Kashayam, Balaguluchadi Tailam external application. Chandanabala Laksha Tailam is also another important area where for application in the Daha condition, Pada Daha, Hasta Daha, in Chandanabala Laksha Tailam is very important. So the last one, as you know well, this is a very popular combination which nowadays certain companies are being marketed by companies. So this is also having direct effect on the diabetic neuropathy improvement and also improve the circulation to the so these two herbs are important ingredients in such formulae. So you can also see that. So another is diabetic, because you know Vrana conditions, there are certain conditions where Vrana is very difficultly to cure. So Kustinam, Vishajustinam, Soshinam, Madhumehinam, Vrana Kritrena Siddhyati. So Vranas are very difficult to manage in these conditions. So especially my observation, I say Guggulu Tikti Gratam, because always I say the quality of medicine is very important. So not by name of the medicine you cannot comprehend, but you have to identify the quality of medicine manufactured by a specific pharmaceutical company. If you follow that quality medicine, then the success will be coming. So Guggulu Tikti Gratam is having excellent healing possibility in diabetic foot in different conditions, about to be amputated, gangrenous condition. Only we take the help of the modern doctors for debridement and cleaning the wound. That's all. But the rest of the things are especially done by ourselves with the internal administration of Guggulu Tikti Gratam, Kaishora Guggulu, Mala Guluchadi Kashayam, Maha Manjishtadi Kashayam, Guggulu Tikti Kashayam. So any of these, but Guggulu Tikti Gratam is the ultimate thing. You can practice and get the results which are very, very effectively seen in many of the patients, and we have number of even documents also for the diabetic foot management. So another is diabetic heart diseases. So because you know diabetes itself is not going to cause any fatality, but by inducing the heart diseases it is going to cause fatal nature. So public awareness, if you see 2000 people with diabetes, 68% do not consider cardiovascular diseases to be the complication of diabetes. Many people do not know that it is a diabetes complication. And another thing which is very important is 50% plus don't feel risk for heart conditions or stroke. 60% don't feel at risk for high blood pressure or cholesterol. Awareness of lowest among the elderly minority people. So that means heart disease is having direct link with the diabetes, because diabetes is very important, but diabetes with heart disease is having comorbidity. You can also find that these are very important comorbidities even for the corona COVID-19. So here very important thing is more than 65% of all deaths in people with diabetes caused by cardiovasculars. So this is actually the back nature that is behind the screen. It kills the individual with the mask of diabetes. So that is the reason why we have to take care of this cardiovascular disorders also. But otherwise, the total glucose level maintenance not only going to give them the longevity and quality of life. Heart attacks occur at an earlier age in people with diabetes, often result in premature deaths. So you also know that diabetes going to have the heart attacks in a silent form. Silent MIs are very commonly seen them. So if a patient gets a pain in chest, he can rush to a modern doctor or ICU and get the proper treatment done. But if you do not feel any pain at all, so they simply ignore that condition and succumb to death. So that is very commonly seen in the diabetics. So up to 60% of adults in diabetes have high blood pressure. This is also another friend. So diabetes with cardiovascular problems, dyslipidemia and blood pressure. So all these are almost confronting them, like the Karna is being confronted. So diabetes one way, and it will invite other friends like diabetes. Diabetes invite even cardiovascular disorders and dyslipidemia and blood pressure. So all these are going to kill ultimately. So very important is cholesterol is also another factor. So but cholesterol in disease condition is very important. Whatever that the suggestions complied by the American Association that is related to the normal individual, cholesterol in disease condition has to be critically viewed. So controlling your cholesterol is very diet regulations, each less saturated fat, food high in saturated fat, fatty meats, high fat dairy products have to be minimized. Tropical oils can be used. Foods high in fiber, very important, oatmeal, beans, peas, and these we will discuss. And take cholesterol lowering medication also, very important, like garlic, methi. All those things are very widely can be used. Exercise regularly. This is a very important point. So coming to the another important area for preventing the cardiovascular diseases is vyayama. So optimum exercise. Optimum exercise is very much advised in modern system. Increased exercise and inadequate exercise, both are harmful, equally harmful. If you are a sedentary life, that is harmful. If it is more than your physical endurance you are doing, that is also harmful. So that is the reason why Ayurveda rightly say, Ardha Shaktya Vyayama, you have to go for half of your physical endurance. So that is very ideal. Even the modern researchers also say, excessive exercise is going to cause harm, and inadequate exercise also going to cause harm, equally harmful for the patients. So now if you see here, this is one study which was conducted in our collaborative work with the SV Institute of Medical Sciences and myself. So terminally, Arjuna was in vitro studies. That means actually it was studied. Terminally, Arjuna was selectively delayed the log phase of LDL oxidation by more than 200 minutes, but did not influence the oxidation of HDL. So that is the beauty, because you know Arjuna is one of the important drugs used for cardiovascular disorders by Ayurvedic doctors. Around 27 internationally published papers are there on Arjuna. More than that even. But international publications, what I am saying. So among these international publications, the terminally Arjuna is considered to be the best for antihypertensive property, best for arrhythmias, best for coronary artery disease, best for congestive heart failure. All these papers are available. So we studied on terminally Arjuna. It has some dyslipidemic effect also. So how it is going to reduce the LDL and increase the HDL. So this is also observed, and this really very important study which was even published. So selective production of LDL against oxidation with Arjuna. Arjuna is having that quality. So this patient's reports on satisfaction with the complementary alternative medicine on diabetes, there was a study. What the patient used to say about using the alternative methods of treatment in diabetes. They say that overall satisfaction is 63.2%. People say they are satisfied with the treatment. So effectiveness, they observed around 66.11% patients say that it is effective. And 99.12% patients say that it doesn't have any side effects. And patient compliance, acceptability, and convenience is there to use. That is in 69.8% people say. Global satisfaction, overall satisfaction, if you take all these aspects covered into 67.33. So that means patients are now moving towards the alternative medicines, no doubt at all. But we have to identify that, properly advise them the diet, properly advise them the lifestyle correction, and advise certain drugs for their management. So to improve the quality, to normalize the glucose levels, and to minimize the complications of diabetes. These are very important. Now coming to the very important herb which I want to share my views with you is Saptarangi. Saptarangi is botanical name is Salacia species. That is, we have oblonga, reticulata, chinensis, so many things are there. But all these are having the similar qualities. So Saptarangi, Vairi, Pitika. So these are different synonyms. in different local areas also. It is a tikta predominant. It is a bitter drug and rutra in quality, laghu, guna in nature. Vipaka is katu vipaka. So if you see here, this what I want to share is this is the expression that means fruits, leaves, inflorescence, roots, and even stem bark. You can see here, saptarangi. So these are the different species of Salacia. Why I am really impressed with this drug is this is really a remarkable medicine which you need to incorporate in your regular practice. That is what I want to say, because after collecting hundreds of research activities done on this saptarangi, the Salacia species, by many Asian doctors, traditional doctors, and even modern doctors, modern biochemists and best scientists, they all say that it's a very excellent medicine for controlling the diabetes and minimizing the complications of diabetes, regulating the obesity, regulating the dyslipidemia. So many things are there, attributes for that. So its chemical composition contains alpha glucosidase inhibitor, that is salicylic. So I told you alpha glucosidase is very important for converting the polysaccharides, disaccharides into monosaccharides at the intestinal level. So if you inhibit this, and it is not going to be converted into monosaccharide, that is glucose, fructose, or galactose, then it is not absorbed into the system. That is the beauty of this. So mangiferin is also another important drug, mangiferin. So we have a series of publications on that. So this I want to share my experiences with you, not because this product is manufactured by Gendu Pharmaceuticals, not because they asked me to speak before you. It is only because it has come from my heart and experience that it is really a remarkable and wonder that I used to prescribe, and patient's feedback is excellent. You can also see the results within no time. By within the first month itself, you can identify by patient feedback that it improves the quality of life, it corrects the fluctuations of the glucose levels, and it regulates the dyslipidemic status, and all these things are possible in this. So it inhibits the intestinal alpha glucosidase, I told you, enhances the messenger RNA expression for hormone sensitive lipase and adiponectin, thus increasing the lipolysis and reducing insulin resistance respectively. So peripheral utility of the glucose and increased sensitivity to the insulin is increased at the periphery. That is very important activity. So significant reduction of HbA1c is seen once you use for 6 weeks to 3 months. Used with vitamin D, significant reduction of weight and BMI is identified. Certain studies effectively improves insulin resistance and glucose metabolism and reduces obesity. So these are very important roots of Salacia, which found to modulate multiple targets. So because this is the beauty of this drug, because many of the herbs having one or two levels of activity to control the diabetes, but it has modulated the multiple targets. So that is the reason why it is having the very important broad spectrum antidiabetic for many of the conditions. So Salacia reticulata in obesity and metabolic disorders, you can see here. In conclusion, it may be stated that Salacia extract treatment decreases the body weight, visceral subcutaneous fat accumulation, and blood glucose. Improvement of abnormal lipid metabolism, fatty liver, and large liver. So this is also one of the important drug for even fatty liver conditions also. Try to understand that. And it regulates the blood pressure. It minimizes or prevents the peripheral neuropathy. So all these studies are worth studies, you can see. And another study from the Salacia species, Chinensis species. This is also in type 2 diabetes. So this is here, mangiferin is one of the phytochemicals present in this Salacia, I told you. The xanthan glucoside as an active phytochemical present in the principal constituent of the Salacia chinensis, Salacia. So indigenous system of medicine, mangiferin is also termed. So this mangiferin, you can see here, levels of blood glucose and urine sugar in control and experimental groups of rats, diabetic control, diabetic with mangiferin. So the remarkable reduction is there. This is a control 252.27. Diabetic model and mangiferin is regulating. Diabetes with glibenclamide is having equally effective nature, and urine sugar is also controlled directly. Here also you can see the urea, creatinine, and uric acid. Usually in the long use of diabetics, we come across the diabetic nephropathy also as a complication. So in diabetic nephropathy, gradual rise of urea, creatinine levels are seen in the individuals. If you use this Celestia species, you can see the reduction of the creatinine when compared with the control. And this is very important thing, which even that quality is not there for glibenclamide, oral hypoglycemic drug given by modern drug. Because many of the oral hypoglycemics given, including the metformin, they are going to worsen the condition of the renal functions. But this is a very important drug which have direct regulation of the obesity, dyslipidemia, blood pressure, and prevention of the atherosclerotic changes, free radical scavenging effect. And in addition to that, very important is it glucosidase inhibition is going to minimize the absorption of glucose from intestines. All these things are very, very much understood in the number of publications here, Celestia reticulata. So diabetes and obesity. So here also I consulted because hundreds of papers are there in Celestia, but hypolipidemic activity, I want to highlight this because of constraint of time. Obesity and metabolic disorders, it's very effective. Celestia has triglycerides lowering property and via hepatic mechanism. That is the reason why it has fatty liver also. It is a very important drug for administration. So statistically significant reduction is there in the lipid parameters, another study shows. And Celestia decreases cardiac hypertrophy. This is also in the course of diabetic cardiopathy. So in that condition, cardiac hypertrophy is also seen. So that can also be minimized in forthcoming, that is complicated stage of the diabetic cardiopathy. So Celestia has hypoglycemic effect that I told you, the fluctuations in the glucose levels can be minimized by administering the Celestia. Celestia attenuates the diabetic renal fibrosis, at least that is what I told you. The renal parameters are minimized. That means creatinine levels are reduced, urea level is reduced. It's very safe to give even for diabetic nephropathy conditions. Celestia possesses nephron protective and antioxidant effects. This was also another study. So anti-diabetic activity, a study was conducted. It was a randomized double-blind crossover study, evaluated the effect of high carbohydrate meal on postprandial glycemia and insulinemia in 66 patients with diabetes. One of the following three meals was consumed by the study subjects in fasting state. So here, a control meal with 240 mg of Celestia extract, control meal with 480 mg of Celestia extract. This was a randomized double-blind crossover study. So here also, it found that it is having better glucose regulation effects on that. So here, Celestia oblonga lowers acute glycemia, lowered the postprandial plasma glucose, is an effective and safe treatment for type 2 diabetes. So you can see here the study results also. I'm showing control group where no Celestia is given, and control with the 240 mg of Celestia, and control with 480 mg of Celestia. So where the mean positive area under the curve for serum glucose concentrations. So concentrations are assessed here, the mg per minimum by deciliter. So here, mean positive area under the curve insulin. So control, this is what actually insulin levels also remarkably reduced once the dose of the 480 mg with the food, controlled food is given. So these two are very important things. Glucose control and insulin levels are also normalized. Glycemic control also seen. So you can see this is baseline and this is control group. And gradually there is a reduction of 115, 98.4, 95.8. Similarly, 165, 143, 142.55 in the baseline, 3 weeks and 6 weeks. That is the reason why at least we have to prescribe 6 weeks for getting the results of Celecia in any individual. If you use for 6 months, this very stable glucose levels are experienced, because some patient used to say that in my total experience of the diabetic patient, I never experienced this type of narrow glucose levels in my life. So that is also expression of some of the patients. So creatinine levels also, you can see 2.7, 2.68, 2.53. So creatinine clearance also gradually 29, 27, 29.8. So here it is also safe for the kidney function, safely it can be given. So now coming to the Celecia extract is marketed by Jandu company as Jan Diabetes. It has two important functions. One is glucose formation from food, inhibiting the alpha glucosidase intestine, which is going to convert the poly and oligosaccharides into monosaccharides, that is inhibited here. So by that, glucose absorption is minimized and glucose from the diet is reduced and blood glucose levels are. And another is insulin secreted from pancreas is increased. Insulin sensitization is also improved. In that way, the glucose levels can be corrected. So in both way, either inhibition at the level of intestines to absorb the glucose, and utilization of the glucose at the different areas by increasing the quantity of the insulin and increasing the sensitivity of the insulin, both ways it is going to control. So it has a poly mechanism, that is the beauty of this drug. So better control, this is what actually this platform which I want to share here. So because even if you practice this, definitely the patient compliance is the testimony for us, not my expression. The patient compliance is the testimony for you. Patient feedback will be experienced by within 6 weeks to 6 months. So to sum up this medical management, pre-diabetic and early diabetic, trustable standalone therapy is there in Ayurveda, no doubt at all. Established diabetics with the uncontrolled plasma glucose level, as an add-on therapy, we can go for that. And add-on therapy is going to minimize the use of the modern system of medicine and improve the quality of life. Fluctuations in the glucose can be minimized. Diabetes with dyslipidemia is the best add-on therapy. And obese diabetics, it is also best adjuvant. It's for all Ayurvedic drugs, I am saying, not for the Celecia alone. Complications of nephropathy and cardiopathy, best adjuvant. So obesity and PCOD also, the Celecia and many of our drugs can be used for the obesity and PCOD managements. So now if Pawan Kumar Sharma ji, can I take some more time for management through?
Please continue, please continue.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much for bearing me. This is dietary management, because this is a very beauty of Ayurveda. Modern system, only they assess the diet in terms of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. That's all. They have gone for only primary metabolites. But in addition to the primary metabolites, secondary metabolites in the food is very, very important for Ayurvedic perspective. What are the secondary metabolites? So many things are there: alkaloids, glycosides, steroids, tannins. So many phytochemicals are there which are incorporated in our food, as because you know that the Masha and Mudga is having more or less same primary nutrients. But if you take the Mudga, is easily available, easily digestible. If you take the Masha effects will be something different. Kapha Utkleshana is going to take. So why this variation is there? Because if you see these both in terms of the modern nutrition, they are after all having the same primary metabolites, like protein content and even fiber content, all those are same. But phytochemicals which are there in it are going to make the changes in it. So usually Ayurveda say the sweet, salty, acidic food, madhura, amla, lavana. So these have to be reduced, because minimized, because they are going to aggravate the kapha. That is what kapha krutya sarvam, whatever that the kapha aggravating factors, all those have to be minimized. Taste of food, kapha producing, whatever that may be. above 3 tests are going to increase the kapha. So opposite for that is katutikta kashaya rasas. So these are ideal food for, if that is the reason why many of the herbs which are having bitter in nature, having hypoglycemic effect. Many of the drugs free from the sweetness, they are having the hypoglycemic effect. So they are, because they are taken as the kapha and going to control the kapha, in that way they are also going to help the diabetics. So various preparations of rice which crops within 60 days, yava, godhuma, kulatha,
they are all grains and pulses.
Barley is another important dietary supplement which is advised exhaustively in almost all Brihathre. So barley is rich in vitamins, minerals and other beneficial plant compounds. It's available in many forms, ranging from hulled barley to barley grits, flakes, flours. Almost all forms of barley utilize the whole grain except for pearl barley. So the barley is a very important diet supplement which is given. The number of recipes also mentioned in Ayurvedic classics to prepare with the barley. So if you see here, it contains magnesium and soluble fiber, may protect against diabetes. So there are 27 trusted sources say that it contains magnesium. 28 trusted sources from the published papers, it says that it is rich in soluble fiber. So these two are very important components for diabetes management. And 30 trusted sources say that barley breakfast provides a lower maximum rise in blood sugar. This is also publications, studies conducted, 30 trusted sources. Breakfast with the barley is going to reduce the sugar. And similarly, 31 trusted sources says that glucose were given either oatmeal or barley flakes daily, which impairs the fasting glucose levels. So barley in one form of food or another form of food is going to give definite lowering blood, glucose lowering effect. Another is chanaka, adaki, mudga and kulutta. These are also widely used in Indian conditions, not a problem, and that new for us. Shamaka is also another samal. So great millets, spiked millets, finger millets, Italian millets, little millets, kodo millets. So these are all different millets nowadays being used by, but millets alone is not advisable. Millets along with the shalidanya, both the combination, the legitimate use of the diet is very, very important advocation as quoted in Ayurveda. So this is Hindi, you can see here different types of millets, what they are called as, and you can also understand that millets are being used by, so not by people. So millets era has come, now many people using the millets and regulating the glucose levels very perfectly. So another oil, what type of oils we have to use, that is another important area. So mustard oil, atasi, agastya, thaila. So these two are the best oils. And in addition to that, the advocation of the tila thaila and even groundnut oil are also used, but legitimately they have to be used. So, but there are photos not yet come. So another is the meat of the animals. Antidiuretic property, baddha mutrati, mutrati. That means there is one thing which is written in Ayurvedic classic, especially Charak Samhita says, Susru Samhita says, that baddha mutrata means the animals which are having less urination, those animals meat is very ideal for diabetics. The reason is not known. So forest animals, forest birds are recommended for that. So methika, patola, karavellaka, tanduliyeka, vastuka, shobhanjan, karkotaka, rasona, kadali. So they are very different vegetables what we use in the regular use in Indian conditions. These can be abundantly used by diabetics. Vegetables consumed by diabetics are all these. We can safely use them. And fruits like oranges, watermelon, apple, guava, jambu, kapitta, amalaki. So all these are also very important fruits which can be used. But excessive sugar containing fruits like grapes, even banana, fully ripened banana, and some aspects of the chiku, these have to be little avoided for that. So mango is also, but in moderation, any fruit is acceptable. So jambu, talafala, that means talafala is also another widely used by the rural people. So they used to eat that pulp. Amalaki, regular use of amalaki is going to increase the innate superoxide dismutase, and it is going to counter the free radical effects on the body. Free radicals are one of the important factors for diabetic complications. Kapitta and Dadima Hinduka, these are also very important fruits which are used. Jambu Pala, these are actually photos are there, not visible here in the Amla. So Kapitta, pomegranate. So now very important to sum up is food that can be used in moderate, that means fat, nuts, cereals, milk products, meat products, eggs, artificial sweeteners. This have to be used in moderation, not in excess. Food that can be completely avoided is sugar, sweet, new honey, jam and jellies, cakes, pastries, sweetened juices and soft drinks. These have to be completely avoided. So now we have different preparations also mentioned in classics, using the fenugreek powder, methika powder, and can be used for the purpose of soaked butter, milk for 3 hours before consumption. Usually fenugreek, how to use it is very important. It can be fried little, make it into powder, and this powder can be soaked in buttermilk at least 3 hours before lunch and before dinner, and this has to be taken before food and then followed by lunch or followed by dinner. So before taking heavy meal, principal meal, this soaked buttermilk with the methika powder soaking in buttermilk for at least 3 hours is a very, very ideal form of administering the methika. So even certain recipes are also available: black gram, red gram, green gram, fenugreek seeds, and these lentils. We can use these recipes discussed in majority of the formulae now, the recipes formulae. So nowadays people are using that dalia lentil soup, and cooked shashtika rice. Tranadanyas are also very important. Barley soaked, the decoction of triphala and kept overnight, should be mixed with old honey. So this is also one expression in the Charaka Samhita. It says Goduma is also another important thing. We do not know the scientific reason behind that. Various eatables prepared from the Yava, Venu, Yava, Goduma, previously eaten by asses, horses, cows and swans, these collected from their dung, should be given to the patient. That means we do not know, probably the calories are being absorbed by them and only the fiber content is excreted through their dung, and that is advised by some classical dietary advisors. They are so ideal ahara is selective food, small meals. You remember always Trivida Kuchhi Ajaya is narrating that. So you have to make the capacity of your food intake into three parts: one part for solid food, one part for liquid food, and one part for aeration. That same formula has to be adopted even for diabetics. Frequent intake is also available, but at least 3 to 4 hours gap must be maintained between the meal. And very important diet advice is previous meal has to be properly digested. Udgara Shuddhi must be there before taking any second meal followed by the previous meal. Foods that can be used frequently: vegetables, green leafy vegetables, spices, high fiber food. Because in Indian conditions, we use around 20 to 30 spices in our regular diet. And these spices are one way or other way going to cleanse our body and detoxicate our body and make our body fit to the normal homeostasis. So now, before concluding this lecture, Susruta has recommended a walking of 100 yojana in 100 days. So really, it's a very beautiful advocation, because Ayurveda not identified the importance of exercise right now. It was mentioned in the Susruta Samhita that he advised 100 yojanas for 100 days. One has to walk, and while walking, he has to leave from his home and he has to beg the alms, and whatever that was got from the people as bhiksha, that has to be taken by them. So different types of food not suit to his cravings, and sometimes you will get excessive food or sometimes even the inadequate food, and you have to walk every day around 7.5 kilometers. One yojana is equal to around approximately 7.5 kilometers. So this is also ideal walking capability of an individual, especially in diabetes. A quotation, nish sukhatvam sukhaya cha. So this is very important. Nish sukhatvam means you have to feel always discomfortable in your life. That means you should not sit in a comfortable posture, comfortable bed, comfortable sitting without any physical activity. All those going to cause asukha for you. Nishukhatvam, if you adopt the nishukhatva, so hard chair, hard bed, and even walking for longer distances, that is going to cause sukhaya cha. It is going to give them sukha, that is arogya for the individual. So this is where very important. Kaphasya upakramam mentioned by Vagbhata is very appropriate for preventing type 2 diabetes. So nishukatvam sukhaya cha is one of the expression for the kapha upakramas. To manage the kapha, this is the best one. So that is what, but that means you have to work hard from morning to evening. And if you are lazy and sedentary, and even sitting posture is comfortable, lying posture is comfortable, that is going to cause asukha for you. That means that is going to induce the disease process. So withdrawing the luxury to create happiness, Stula Pramiha are advised to do exercise like wrestling, horse riding, vigorous walking, and Krisha Pramiha are advised to protect their strength, not to do exercise. So these both are advised in Ayurvedic classics regarding the vihara. So Patya Vihara for diabetics in Ayurveda is also advocated in Ayurvedic classics. This is not an imitation from modern system. So I referred the following journals for my supplementing the research material done by other scientists, conducted by my institute, by me, with collaboration of SV Institute of Medical Sciences. All these things are done. So thank you for listening to me. Thank you one and all, and especially thank Pavanji for giving me this opportunity to share my views with this platform with the August audience. Okay, thank you, sir.
One question was there, doctor.
Yeah.
From Dr. Sumita Jaiswal, I hope.
Very good.
Whether we completely cure this, completely reverse T2 diabetes, Dr. Sumita Kundra.
This is my experience, Sumitaji. If they come within 1 year of identifying themselves as diabetics, if they come with a pre-diabetic stage, we can completely reverse the condition with all the trifold approach, with diet regulation, drug administration, and also exercise. So if they come after 1 year, as we have to obey the classics also, classics say that after 1 year, it will become yapya. So you have to manage that. The management is only to improve the quality of life and to minimize complications, and also you have to increase the span of life. These are all objectives of either a modern doctor or an Ayurvedic doctor. So if it is more than 1 year, we have to manage palliatively. That means apya, it will become apya. And if it is less than 1 year, we can definitely reverse the condition. There are several people who received treatment from us and they got free from that. But once they breach the nature's law, that again they go for high calorie food, sedentary life, after 3 or 4 years they may get back and again they assume the same treatment and they will be normalized. So not a problem at all. Reversibility is there if they come before 1 year or if they come with the pre-diabetic stage.
I have a question. Hello?
Please tell me.
Yes, and Dr. Sujata Guha, do you continue allopathic medicines along with the Ayurvedic recommendations? Because I'm having
yeah,
a
I told you there are one aspect. If it is less than 1 year, we need not go for allopathic medicine. Even if the allopathic medicine is there already being taken by the patient, we can withdraw that gradually and go for Ayurvedic management with the trifold approach like diet, exercise and our drug. Suppose if it is more than 1 year, already patient is chronic. That means taking treatment for last 10 years from modern doctor, having bunch of drugs, modern drugs. In that condition, by introducing as an add-on therapy for their existing modern medication, the quality of life and fluctuations in the glucose levels can be minimized. That what I told you, several patients expressed that after using the medicine, never I experienced this type of narrow ranges of my fasting and postprandial blood sugar, sir. Earlier when I used the modern medicine, that was not there even by using the insulin. But once we start using Ayurvedic medicine, fluctuations of the glucose levels can be minimized. That's a very, very important task to minimize the complications of diabetes. So this is a very, very important observation which I want to say. But we cannot completely withdraw the modern medicine, but gradually the modern doctors along with our treatment, they can reduce even the doses also. We come across the insulin doses are reduced, oral hypoglycemic doses where the three combinations are coming to two combinations into one combination. That minimization is possible because here we have a drug act, we cannot handle the modern drugs. So we always advise the doctor to patient to go for a modern doctor. So we have a good fraternity here, modern doctors fraternity. They support because we are after all working for the same cause of patient. So they don't mind even reducing the doses if it is well maintained. So this possibility is there. With the good fraternity, you can handle the modern system of medicine, gradually decreasing the doses from modern side and managing from our side and minimizing the complications, improving the quality of life, fluctuating. All these things are possible. And certain, especially certain complications like diabetic neuropathy, there is no medicine.
I am Dr. Manoj Kumar Agarwal. I have three questions.
Yeah.
Is there any already concept in diabetes management? Number one. Number two, I have treated. Is there any Avaran concept in diabetes management?
Avaran, yeah, definitely. I told you because you haven't listened to me probably. There are two things. Sahaja Prameha, that is Jata Prameha. That is one. And second one is the disease which we say as a Stula Prameha. This is nothing but Avarana Janya only. So that is the reason why, because always you remember, though all the pranayas are tridosha janya in nature. Basically, they are not a single dosha. But in spite of that, we say that vataja prameha, pittaja prameha, kafaja, because a little acceleration of that is there. But avarana is one of the important underlying pathology for the genesis of the prameha, that is no doubt at all. So this is discussed in the
second question.
Chakrapani's commentary of Charakasamhita also.
Thank you, sir. Second question, sir. Sir, second question. In your practice, you are treating the case as a 1 year, less than 1 year cases or on the dosa assessment. And what are the criteria for the dosa assessment for a diabetes management for the practical point of view?
Really, really very important, because usually that what I told you is for general doctors, but if you go for the very critical analysis of doshic management, we have to come down to the level of the assessment of etiological factors, very, very important. So etiological factors assessment is very important, and even kapha aggravating factors, we have to identify what type of kapha aggravating factors are exposed by the individual before coming to us. Certain people, they expose to only kapha aggravating factors. Sometimes they expose even to a lot of stressful situations, that is a vata aggravating factor. And accordingly, you have to identify. But always you remember that whenever you think in lines of Ayurvedic medicine, you have to keep in your mind that katutikta kashayasa pradhana dravyas have to be given, and guru ahara has to be given, But you may immediately ask, Guru Ahara is going to aggravate the kapha. But especially Guru Ahara is a very, very essential thing to minimize the intake of food. That is also because even Stholyam also, Guru Chapatarpanam Yadha Madhu, it is said. Gurutva is very important for minimizing the agni, minimizing the agni. That is very, very important. So Guru Ahara, Katutikta Kashayarasa Pradhana drugs and even diet also to be given. And you can go for even Vyadhi Pratyanika treatments like Chandra Prabhavati if you say, Vasant Kusumakarasa if you say, they are all Vyadhi Pratyanika Chikichas. They are broad spectrums only. Nisha Katakadi Kashayam, Kataka Kadiradi Kashayam, these are all actual broad spectrums. So you can properly assess, but always you remember whenever you keep the diabetic in mind, whether he's a Stula Pramehi or Krishna Pramehi. The difference of treatment is 100% variable when compared with the Stula Pramehi and Krishna Pramehi. In the Stula Pramehi, you have to go for the general principle of Madhumeha, not a problem. Even you can do the Shodhana also. We come across the Shodhana in them, and once Shodhana is done, even if they are a diabetic, their requirement of the modern medicine is remarkably reduced by simple Shodhana. Okay? Vaman Virechana, and if you plan out, so you can sensitize the total body and you can minimize even the use of modern drugs. But once it comes to the Krishya Pramehi, their problems comes where you need to go for the Brahmana drugs and at the same time Brahmana without aggravating the kapha. So that is also very important.
Yes.
And these Brahmana drugs have to be carefully given and properly digestible and laghu in nature, but easily digestible. And it may contain even the madhura, but with less calorie drugs are there, even madhu.
Any suggestion, any suggestion of drugs like this?
So that what I do. A lot of drugs, a lot of diet as mentioned, you know. So the important things is pulses. Yava. Yava is widely discussed in Yava is a very, very important drug for that. But for that is for
after 6 months, sir.
Stula Pramehi only. Yava is meant for Stula Pramehi. Pulses. Anyas are also for Stula Pramehi. Millets are also advised for the Stula Pramehi. You remember. Once it comes to this Krishya Pramehi, the approach is little different. That what I told you, the Mamsa Rasas are advised. Mamsa Rasas are very ideal for them. If the Mamsa Rasas are taken properly. If the chira is given, chira has to be processed with kapara drugs. Then chira can be given. So like that, mudga, masa, yushas can also be given. So soups are also managed by the brahmana purpose. Sattu is also given without aggravating the kapha. So these are all you have to manage accordingly, but categorize them. Even approach of modern system, approach of Ayurveda system is nothing different. So even modern doctors also take lean and thin diabetic and modest diabetic. But Ayurveda also says Stula Pramehi Balava Nihayika Krushastha Danyar Paridurbhalasya Sabrahmanam Tatra Krushasya Karyam Samshodhanam Dosha Baladikasya. That is what our line of treatment is also similar. So we have to carefully monitor. Purusham Purusham Vichya is very important. You cannot generalize. But certain drugs are there, you can generalize with you. So those drugs which I told you, like Vasant Kusumakarasa, can be given 10 days, once in 3 months. Regularly you can go. Mm-hmm. So you can prevent the complications of diabetes. No doubt at all. Chandra Prabhavati can be given in both conditions, even Krishya Pramehi, Stula Pramehi. But I found that Salacia is more effective in Stula Pramehi rather than Krishya Pramehi. This is also identified. So these possibilities, so you go for minutest details. But based on that minutest details, you can give appropriate advocation to the patient.
Sir, one patient I have treated, around 60 years old, male patient with symptoms of prostatism, diabetes, hypertension, on allopathic drug with CKD of creatinine 2.6. With the treatment of Chandra Prabha and diet regime and also the Vihara like walking, patient come to control. Hello.
I am listening you. I am listening you.
Sir, that patient come to control in a fasting sugar of 130 and PP sugar also 176 from the range of 250 to 300 like this. And CKD was also managed and come to the normal level. But after suddenly 6 months later, 6 months later, suddenly the sugar level moved to again 300 and beyond, both fasting and PP. What was the reason?
So usually you see, that is what I told you in the very beginning. So whenever the patient comes to you for follow-up visits, you have to appraise them again, brief them the importance of diet, importance of lifestyle, importance of using the medicines regularly. So if they use regularly all these three things, there will not be any problem. But once they get relief, there is a tendency in diabetics that definitely they, if the glucose levels are normalized, they simply deviate from the norms. They go for the diet, erroneous diet, and they go for even sedentary life or using of the medicines.
This patient, I visited their home also. But and he followed because I've inquired from their family all member also. I don't come to any region.
Stress also. One of the factors is stress. Sedentary life, stress, or another.
That is one of the factors, right, sir?
Stress has to be considered very importantly because such patients, if everything is as it is, if there is a sudden rise of sugar, means he probably lot of unconscious emotions, subconscious emotions. We have to ventilate them. There is no other way.
Yes, sir. Correct. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, doctor. I hope this meeting was informative.